The workflow in a typical SOC begins by triaging the incident queue. It's like how you triage your inbox to focus on important messages. But triaging a busy incident queue can raise your heart rate a good bit more. Most of the incidents in your queue are truly malicious, true positives, while some are benign and were raised by mistake, false positives. Just like your inbox, you can triage false positives right from the start. Get them out of the way so you can focus on the important incidents, the true positives. Then you can move on to investigating, containing, and remediating them. In Microsoft 365 Defender, you can classify each incident or alert as a false or true positive in the portal, or as expected activity like security testing. Aside from helping you focus on true positives, classifying incidents has added benefits, and we really want you to get in the habit of doing this. First, classification helps SOCs more easily triage new incidents and share knowledge based on a history of similar items. For example, junior analysts can learn from expert analysts by reviewing their recent classification decisions and notes. Second, we collect anonymous statistics on incident and alert classifications across all our customers. Our researchers use this data to spot unusual spikes in false positives. When they see it impacting a lot of customers, they'll improve detection for everyone to prevent the false positive from happening again. In that way, classifying your false positives contributes to detection quality, not just for yourself, but for all our customers. That's one reason why classifying items as informational, expected activity during security testing is important. Classifying those test items as false positive might tune the detection to the point that we miss those activities when a malicious actor does them. Third, classifying items helps you to track trends in their quality. For example, you can identify false positives due to certain apps or scripts that are unique to your organization. That information can help to improve the quality of the incidents queue by reducing related false positives. However, just classifying an item that is unique to your organization as false positive doesn't automatically prevent it from occurring again. That is, Microsoft won't tune the detection across all our customers. Those items will continue to show up in the queue until you do something to stop them. And to do that, you might need to make changes in your environment. Try to understand what activity or characteristic looks malicious and rework to eliminate it. Classifying an incident is super easy, and you can do it as soon as you've determined the activity's malicious nature. That's true even if you haven't resolved the item yet. Do that in the incident queue or details page. We'll start with the queue. Select an incident to open the side pane, and then select Manage Incident. Then select a determination from the classification list. You can choose a true positive, informational, or false positive determination. The classification and determination are no longer in two different lists, so fewer clicks. Last, we recommend that you add a comment to document your decision. That comment might come in handy later when you or other analysts investigate similar incidents. Classifying an incident on its detail page is the same. To get started, select Manage Incident. Like before, select a determination and add a comment. When you classify an incident, all its unclassified alerts inherit that decision. That might be great in most cases, but if you want, you can also classify alerts individually. For example, some phishing, some malware. As with incidents, you can classify alerts in the alerts list or on an alert page. In the alerts queue, select an alert to open the side pane and select Manage Alert. Like before, choose a determination and document your decision. On an alert page, you do the exact same. We encourage you to classify incidents and alerts to help streamline your SOC workflow and to help improve detection for your environment and others. To learn more about classification in Microsoft 365 Defender, see our documentation on Microsoft Docs. Microsoft Security.